Okay guys, so the ending video for Reaper Tutorials is here, and we're going to be going over how to choose an audio interface for specifically things like either podcasting or voice over video. Technically, it's called voiceovers. You can use them for many different things, but we're going to focus on video as we have done for all the Reaper tutorials. So, choosing audio interface. Let's move over to a website called musiciansfriend.com. You can go there, and they've got all the great prices out there. And we're going to look at three different products today, and then I'm going to go over maybe a few different products that you may want to look at if you want higher-end audio tracking and more features. We're going to start off with the Audio-Technica AT2020. It's a USB condenser microphone. Now, this will pick up everything in a room, so you don't want to be in a noisy location. It is condenser. That means it's really, really... It picks up a lot of noise around the room. It's really sensitive to the environment is what I was looking for. The nice thing, though, that is featured in this microphone that you don't get with most microphones is it's USB. So you can plug this into the USB slot on your computer. It'll install a driver, maybe a little bit of software, and you're good to go. You don't need any type of hardware or anything, but that's it. Now, the next one is a USB interface as well. However, this doesn't come with a microphone. This is simply an audio interface. What you will need is a dynamic microphone such as a Shure SM58, and you'll plug that in. It'll plug in via a microphone cable with XLR leads at each end. That's a standard microphone cable these days for pro audio. It'll plug in any of these two inputs on the front of this unit. This is the M-Audio Fast Track Pro USB and MIDI interface, but it runs on USB. Great product. It runs about $200, as you can see. Now, the nice thing about this is you're not just limited to using a microphone. If you wanted to track music and maybe you're maybe you have a guitar or something, or you're a musician, you can plug in any of your instruments or anything like that and start recording and use this as the sound card. It actually bypasses the sound card in your computer for playback and input, which is nice because you get a really nice signal all around. Now let's move up to this one. This is the Presonus Firebox. It's a FireWire interface. Now, what I mean by FireWire is it comes with a different type of lead. As you can see on the back here, it comes with a 6-pin FireWire input. And that's also an output. The interesting thing between USB and FireWire comes when you have more than two inputs. Most USB interfaces only track two inputs, and if they have more inputs on the front, they mix everything down. So if you were to record three different microphones, say three people talking, and you wanted to track them to three different sources in your software, which you're looking to next, such as Reaper, you wouldn't be able to do that because it would just mix it down one or two different tracks. That's gonna be hard to process and edit later. So go with FireWire if you need more than two inputs on the front. This one does feature two inputs in the front. However, on the back, they give you plenty of inputs and a lot of outputs too, which is nice. So this is a step up. Be sure your computer does have either a 4-pin or 6-pin FireWire connection. Sometimes it's called IEEE 1694 or something like that. Or if you have like a Sony camera, I should say, it's called iLink. There's a bunch of different names, but FireWire is the most common name. So if you go around a music store or something asking about that, that's what they'll probably point you out to. So those are the three interfaces. Now let's look up one more by Presonus, and this is going to be the Fire Studio Project. This one will run you about $400 to $500. This is a restock for $400, but generally it goes for $500 new. Now the nice thing about this is it has that same FireWire interface in the back, those two 6-pin ports. You only have to plug one into your computer. The second one is used to daisy chain more of these. You can daisy chain three of these interfaces. Now if you look at the front of this though, you'll notice how many inputs it has. 8 inputs. Now this is nice for you people that are doing voiceovers. Maybe you're doing a cartoon and you want to start off with the script and then track all the vocals at once. You can have 8 people on 8 different microphones. They can record 8 different tracks in Reaper, which we looked at before, or any type of software that you're working with to edit and record the audio, and they're not mixed down at all. 8 different tracks, 8 inputs, and me personally, I use a PreSonus FP10, which is the lower model from this, and PreSonus does a really darn good job at making their drivers for their newer products. They may not be great for the older ones. I'm working on a gear review for my FP10 right now. The only thing I find bad about it is the front mount jacks are not the best for my studio personally. But the other thing that's really annoying to me right now is the fact that they don't have any drivers out for Windows 7. It's been out for quite some time. That operating system is just outstanding, so that's holding me back. But anyway, that's a different story for a different day. So anyway, I just wanted to go over these four different products. And just be note to yourself that if you don't have an audio interface, you probably will want to get one. But if you're on a budget, I do suggest getting the Audio-Technica AT2020 USB condenser microphone. Work with it in a quiet location and you'll have fantastic results. If you're going to work in a noisy location, you may want to get something like the Shure SM58 and an M-Audio FastTrack Pro USB interface, or even the PreSonus FP10 or Fire Studio Project, or better yet, on the lower budget once again, the PreSonus Firebox, which has two inputs on the front and two main on the back. So with that said, guys, this is wrapping up all the tutorials on Reaper and how to do voiceover work and everything for video. We've looked over Reaper, pretty much all the features on there, but there is still a lot to go over. As I said before, I don't have the time to go over here, and you don't need me going over every little detail to learn about the program. There's three different sources of information on the program itself. There's lots of information on the web on how to get to into recording. And one thing before I go, I want to point you out to Tweaks Guide. If you Google Tweaks Guide or Tweakheads Lab, you can get to this page, and there's just a huge information source here. You don't see it at the left because it is cut off by the recorder, but there's just probably over 50 links off to the left on different specific things on how to do recording at home or in your project studio. Everything from the home recording down to the advanced stuff. Read over it a few times. It's taught me a heck of a lot over the years, and I don't know where I'd be without it these days, so check it out. I'm Dave from Sonic Rip Studios, guys. I want to thank you for watching all these videos and keeping track of all them. And for now, I'm out of here, and I'll see you next time.